We give you glory, Lord, as we worship you. We give you glory.
We give you glory, Lord,
glory, Lord,
as we honor you.
You are,
you are wonderful.
You are
worthy, oh
Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, cleanse me, spirit, soul, and body. Make me whole and holy. Remove every unrighteousness from my life. In the name of Jesus. Father, cleanse me, spirit, soul, and body. By the blood of Jesus. Make me whole. Make me holy. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Say, Father, every satanic plantation in my life, by the power in the blood of Jesus, and by the fire of the Holy Ghost, let all be uprooted and destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let every satanic plantation in my life be uprooted and destroyed. Every satanic plantation in my life, uproot and destroy. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I perceive that the enemy has planned death for somebody or somebody in somebody's family. Wow, we are going to pray and say, Father, every death that has been programmed, every accident that has been programmed, every evil that has been programmed, for me or any member of my family, or anyone I'm connected to, I command back to center in the name of Jesus. Go back to Satan. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Anything that the enemy is doing concerning you, God will frustrate. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, divine frustrate every activity of the enemy in my life. In the name of Jesus, divine frustrate. Father, in Jesus' name, see.
Power to heal.
Power to prosper.
Power to make progress.
Grant unto me this power in the name of Jesus to benefit my life. You are the custodian of all power. Father, grant unto me the power to heal, to save, to prosper, to make progress. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Don't tell us, you tell somebody here, your star will start to shine. Power belongs to you. Power belongs to you. In heaven and in earth. For me, and let the difficult thing become easy. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Hey, Father, every garment of sorrow, garment of failure, garment of frustration, garment of loneliness, garment of barrenness, garment of evil, garment of sickness, that they be upon me in the realm of the spirit, remove and destroy by fire. Garment of lighter settlement, garment of progress, place upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, let the garment, glorious garment, honorable garment. Thank you. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The God of mercy will visit you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
While I was away, there's a song that I learned. You know, I just woke up one day and the song was just screaming before me on the TV. And every day I've been listening to that song, I've been singing it. Should I teach you?
Yes.
Okay. She said, Omekola Mazo.
Omekola Mazo.
I don't put you on free. I don't put you on free. Chidebere. No, Chidebere. Oh, Chidebere. Omekola Mosa. Ewo. Omekola Mosa. He has taken away my sorrow.
Omekola Mosa.
Oh, Something and that thing have not been people even try to help, but they could not help. But the miracle, you just settle everything. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, the miracles I need to settle all my needs from today, release unto me in the name of Jesus. The miracles that I need to settle all my needs from this very day, please release unto me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Miracle worker, you are the miracle worker.
Thank you.
Now, bless us,
yeah.
Teach us,
yeah.
Open our eyes,
yeah.
And let all the glory be yours forever.
Yeah.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed.
Yeah.
Put your hands together for Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Once again, I miss you. Mind your business part. In fact, don't worry about it. Mind your business part in it. Eh? 64. 62, 64. Part 63. Mind your business part 63. We are going to be talking about divine strategy for open doors. Who wants open doors in your life in this place? Yeah, I want to. Divine strategy for open door. In the book of Genesis chapter 42, 6 and 7. Genesis 42, 6 and 7, you will read the account of Joseph finding himself as the governor in Egypt. And his brother now came to him. Those brothers are dead with him. And they came to him. And they bowed before him. I'm prophesying to your life. Everyone that had mocked you or that had been against you before 30 days of the day, God will structure things in the realm of the spirit that will call them to bow to you. In the name of Jesus. Let's read. And Joseph was the governor over the land. And he it was that sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brethren came and bowed down themselves before him with their faces to the earth. And Joseph saw his brethren, and he knew them, but made himself strange unto them, and spake roughly unto them. And he said unto them, whence come ye? And they said, from the land of Canaan, to buy food. Praise the Lord. And Joseph knew his brethren. Let's just add that verse to it. But what happened? He did not know him. You know, you must have heard in some quarters before that when the purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. The elder sometimes say that when God is doing good, sometimes you may think he is bad. You may not know. That is an encouragement to you. Eh? You may be going through some things that are not palatable. Don't worry. Our God is going to work everything together for your good.
Yeah.
You know, I've always read this scripture, this part of the scripture, and I've always seen it that serve them right. Maybe they dealt with it. Now they have come to bow to him, and he will deal with them. That was how I used to read it. But last week, God opened my eyes to another area in that scripture. Joseph was the open door for them to access the wealth of Egypt. God had planted Joseph there to help them in the time of famine. God already, God knows the end from the beginning. God had already known that there will be a season of famine, and he had already planted Joseph in Egypt. Egypt is a type of worldly system. When you look at the book of Ezekiel chapter 20 verse 7, Ezekiel 27, you will read it there that Egypt happened to be Ezekiel 27. Yes, said I unto them, cast ye away every man the abomination of his eyes, and defy not yourself with the idols of Egypt, and the Lord your God. How come God now planted somebody there? How come God planted his own man inside there? That's why I pity many people that talk in ignorance. When God is doing some things, this one is a Christian. What is he finding in policies? This one is a, this is the Christian. They are bringing an unbeliever to be in their midst. They lack understanding of God's working. God is strategically planting some things there. But they are not aware. And they are busy running their mouths, not understanding that God is the God. Yes, they are idle, but he wants somebody that will come inside their midst. Or he will anoint somebody in their midst. And it starts changing the situation strategy. But they lack understanding of God's strategy. God will always put a man inside a place that he needs a change. Or he will always change a man inside a place that he needs a change. But he don't understand. But if God could reveal to you, the Bible said that God does not do anything but reveal to some of his prophets. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. But they will not understand. They just don't know. They don't know what God is doing in the place. Praise God. But God already planted Joseph there. See them, they wanted to kill him. They didn't know that they were killing their open doors. But God had planted him there. In fact, when the father was sent for, because in the book of Genesis, okay, let me read Genesis chapter 45. 45, I think 7. Genesis 45, 7. And God sent me before you to preserve you a posterity in the earth and to save your life by a great deliverance. Joseph was saying it. That God has sent me to, who will have thought that is Egypt? Place of idolatry, place of abomination, that God will now send his child there. When God is doing something, keep short if you don't know what he's doing. Especially in the politics of our nation. When people are busy running about, they are letting somebody they are doing, they don't understand strategy. Strategy. God is about to change something in your life. Yeah. And by the reason of this unction that is flowing into your life, it's beginning today. Yeah. And it will be quick and settled. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. In fact, when the father was sent for in the book of Genesis chapter 46, 3 and 4, the father was reluctant. He did not want to go to Egypt. But God appeared to him in a dream. Go down to Egypt. Christian, how can they don't understand God's strategy? And he said, I am God, the God of thy father. Fear not to go down into Egypt, for I will there make thee a great nation. I will go down with thee in into the into Egypt, and I will also surely bring thee up again. And Joseph shall put them, his hand upon thy eyes. Praise the Lord. And when you read Genesis 47, I think 6 and 7 or something. And it was 47 from 5. And Pharaoh spake unto Joseph, saying, thy father and thy brethren are come unto thee. The land of Egypt is before thee. In the best of the land, make thy father and brethren to dwell. In the land of Goshen, let them dwell. And if thou knowest any men of activity among them, then make them rulers over my cattle. Oh my God. I'm talking about divine strategy to open door. Joseph was that open door. And God has already planted. What is that? This got to do with mind your business. In business, in whatever you do, you will need to go to some setting, to some establishment, to some embassy. And God needs to have put somebody there to favor you. You will not know the person. He didn't know Joseph. But Joseph knew them. The person will know you. Not physically knowing you that you have met before. In the realm of the spirit, God has already ordered the person. Open the door for this one. Divine strategy. Moses was God's open door for the Israelites. They wanted to kill him. One time they were trying to even settle their matter. They wanted to kill him. He don't know that God will always somehow put somebody there so that there will come a time the person will now be their open door to their freedom. Esther was the open door to the freedom of the Jews. That is God's style. Have you not seen it? You will always need contract somewhere. You will always need to go for a job, to seek for a job in a higher place. Then this scripture will come alive that you will need God to have put somebody there. Somebody that will know you. I just like this person. I just want to give you the life. God has already made the person to know you in the realm of the spirit. To open the door. I'll prophesy into your life in whatever business you do. You start experiencing open door.
Amen.
I say you start experiencing open door.
Amen.
I told you several years of a particular time when I was doing my master's thesis. And I went to a particular establishment. I was just saying, let me just go because it happened to be an international establishment. When I got there, I was waiting for the number one person, the manager, the director. A German lady, and she was not here then, so I was waiting. But I was observing everything that was happening. The lady, she came, and the driver and the PA, the way they were just running a task scattered with reference, within me, I was saying that, with this woman even give me audience, within me. And as she came in, all of them stood up and they were, welcome her, and she just walked past. I said, well, no problem. Father, it is known that I will get. Just as I was telling you yesterday in the doctor. So, I filled the form. And shortly, she sent for me. As I entered the office, a young man, how may I help you? I said, I'm from so school. I've come to do a research. I just want to get some information or material from the establishment. Okay, no problem. She just buy. And I called the secretary, pressed something, and the secretary came. I said that, take this one man to the library and take care of him. Ah, thank you, ma'am. When I got there, come and see more than what I needed. And she now told them to give me some journals, free. And as I was doing my research, they gave me drink to drink. Something to be munching. I was just enjoying life as I was doing it. And I went there after I was already finished. I went there to come and thank her. I said, are you satisfied? I said, yes, I'm satisfied. But not satisfied. There's another place which is more practical than where we are. you can go there, it's in another state. Me, when I calculated another 6 months, I always say I'm satisfied. And she said that, but I can tell them to take you there in the car because they will be going there. I said, okay, I will go. 3 days I was not in their guest house. They were feeding me. It got to a time that I was afraid because, you know, they said that Christmas chicken, you keep before something will not happen. Because nobody knew where I was. But because the long story short, I just enjoyed my stay there. The people treated me because they realized that I was coming from the director. And when I was going, I was giving even more than enough money to transport me back to school. And I see her extra. She knew me. I did not know her. God had planted her there for me to be the open door, to have access to all their facilities. Just like Cyril was saying, Joseph, your father and brother, anything that they want in this whole land, grant it unto them. I prophesy into your life. The open door into that your career breakthrough, that your marital breakthrough, that health breakthrough, receive in the name of Jesus. You know, to one of my colleagues, that end of my story. Yeah, folks, here's the place. She got the place. And she now said she would go. She now went. But anyway, she now came back later and said, father. See, she really said that these people were generous and very nice. I said, come on, pure water. She said, come on, pure water. The door was not open to her. It's me that had that open door. By the time the Israelites got to the Red Sea, there was open door. The Egyptian thought that that open door was for them. What happened again? I'm prophesying into your life that the open door that you need to get to the place of your destiny, let it be unto you now in the name of God. In your business prosperity, let the open door be. How do you get this open door quickly? How do you know the open door? Pray. The Bible says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3. Jeremiah 33:3. Come unto me and I will show you. Then you need also to pray in the Holy Ghost. John chapter 16:13-15. Bible says that he will lead you to that which God had already provided for you. Shall we rise to our feet and pray and say, Father, divine strategy that you have already instituted for my opening, connect me with in the name of Jesus. Connect me with. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, we thank you because you have just given us not just a message, but a prophetic message that you have already placed some people there to grant us access to what we have been looking for. Let us start experiencing that in our businesses and other areas of our lives. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let me go.